Έχουμε παίξει πάρα πολλές φορές σε συναυλίες για πολιτικούς κρατούμενους.
They were attacking migrants every day, like on the streets, they were bashing them up. They actually killed a few as well, but didn't kind of make the news too much. But then they killed the Greek guy, who was the rapper, who we all know at the end. And then kind of people took notice. But these are serious things. In Australia, we don't quite have these things. We do have certain things, of course, but it's at a smaller level, it's a smaller scale.
Good with your film. One of the things that came up was a blog from Thailand called Limitless Cinema. It was interesting that that person is in fact envious at the level of freedom
people have. The Greeks express these things. Yeah, in Thailand, he finds that even as a writer on a blog, he can't fully express himself, and the filmmakers certainly in Thailand can't express themselves. Yeah. Look, it's the same in Turkey and Russia. We saw Pussy Riot in Russia. You know, in Turkey, the government imprisons journalists all the time, and I think artists as well. So Greece has got that really great thing about it, in that it's a problematic country, and there's corruption, and there's politicians who are like Tsipras, who's like a saviour, but fucks it all up. But you know, they've got those bad things, but then the Greeks also have this expression, and look at this love of life. So, and community and family, and really do fight. You know, I personally was like very impressed when the Golden Dawn murdered the Greek guy, the Greek rapper, the Greek hip hop artist. The week after, I was there, and I saw all the anarchists kind of gathered together, you know, in a big square. They were going to march to the offices of the Golden Dawn to, you know, set fire to the place and really try and get them. Of course, they couldn't do that, but the government responded. And anyway, these are anarchists. There must have been like a few thousand of them on the ground. And the passion, you know, their belief in trying to correct this wrong that happened, you know, was incredible. You know, so Greeks have that. And what can I say? It's, let's hope they always have it. They always kind of help to make life better.
By this film, and also you've made films both in Europe and in an Australian context. I'm wondering how this kind of internationalism or transnationalism has shaped your vision as a filmmaker. What does that mean to you?
I think obviously I'm connected to Australia and Greece only, not to other countries, but I've seen cinema from other countries. I don't know, I guess you kind of, you know, feel for people that you don't, you know, fully know. And so the whole kind of thing of compassion and understanding kind of comes into play. And for me, I don't know, I go, even though I'm Greek heritage, I'm like an outsider when I go to Greece and film all this. And interestingly enough, I get an interesting response like that from the people there, the audience. See that this person has come from outside Greece and has made this film, and they sort of wonder, you know, what does that mean? And does he see things a bit differently to us? Can we learn something from it? So there is an exchange as well between Australia and Greece, in effect, for this. I'm not sure if you can be more specific.
Or maybe international. What lessons can we learn from this film? In a local context.
We in Australia?
Yeah.
I think you just basically to see a society and see a people that doesn't actually get represented you know, on the screen too much within Australia. You might, you know, on ABC and other places in the last 10 years, we've had stories about, you know, riots and the Greek crisis and certain things like that. But I think what I show is just a little bit more on the ground and a little rougher, a little prickly, something like that.